bring with you? Anybody here over the age of 109?
109? They're all 109 here, folks. Here they come. Oh, dear, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, keep taking the hormone tablets. Watch that fellow. Oh, dear. Steady, Bill. Steady, Bill. 18 marriages and still doing it. Never mind, Bill.
Now, I suppose you're all... Simmer down. I suppose you're all wondering why I've asked you here tonight. Well, I tell you, dearly beloved brethren, we are gathered here this evening in the sight of Val Parnell and his creditors to make money.
Hi, I'm Greg Englert. I'm a musician and composer who lives on the central coast of New South Wales. I'm here today at Woy Woy to follow an interesting thing I found back in 2018. I was playing in a jazz band at the Woy Woy Library for the opening of the Spike Milligan exhibit. And while I was playing there, I spotted this instrument, a brass instrument, in a case. And I said, "What's that?" And they said, "Oh, that was Spike's trumpet." And that he was a trumpet player. Now, I grew up listening to the Goons and never knew that about him. So it became quite an interesting thing, and I became friends with Spike's daughter, Laura. And as a result, I said to Laura, "Look, I've played Louis Armstrong's trumpets in New York. I'd like to play Spike Milligan's cornet." So it's happening. So I'm doing this short film, and we're basically going to head now to the Woy Woy Library and talk to Geoff Potter about the instrument, and let's see where it takes us. But as you can see, one of the most beautiful places, Woy Woy, New South Wales, made famous by the one and only Spike Milligan.
Well, tonight is not the 104th anniversary of the death of Chopin. So, to celebrate that occasion, I was going to play one of Chopin's etudes, and then I thought, why should I? He never plays any of mine. Anybody to do that? Instead, a little poem that I wrote.
A little poem by Spike Milligan.
There was a young man called Wyatt, whose voice was remarkably quiet, and then one day it faded away.
Okay, so I'm here outside the Woy Woy Public Library, and I'm here today to look at the exhibit, the Spike Milligan exhibit, and talk to Geoff Potter, the custodian and the man keeping alive the memory of Spike Milligan. So let's go and have a look in the library and see what we have to find.
Okay. On the cornet case that Spike Milligan's cornet belongs to, there are two very important addresses that show parts of his life and two very important places in his life. And one, which is local to where we are now at Woy Woy, is the address written on the front here, 393 or 392. Orange Grove Road, Woy Woy, New South Wales. So that's one important place. Now, Spike was a traveller, and as part of his radio work and performing work and that, he went around the world. But the other place central to Spike and his success is his office, which was in Orme Court, O-R-M-E, Court in London, and it's written here on the top, which unfortunately is very faded, but and I think it's number 9 Orme Court, London. So on that little case he's put two addresses that are very important to him.
Okay, the very first thing that I've noticed is it's a normal cornet, but as you can see, it's got a trumpet mouthpiece. So it's got a trumpet lead pipe. Now, I brought along a cornet mouthpiece. Absolutely no use. So like everything we're going to find in this, I think that's the first of many, 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 many interesting things that are just going to pop up. So I'm going to have a look at it now and just see if we can find a brand name and a serial number and go from there. Yeah, the valve action is absolutely amazing for the age. That's not even oiled. We haven't even bothered to put oil on it yet. Massively good valves. Just going to check the valves.
Yeah.
It's in very good condition. As you can see, the patina is fantastic. It hasn't got a dent on it.
Yeah.
Hasn't even got a scratch. So the valves, let's see how conditioned the valves are in.
I'll send you the various photographs.
Okay, thank you.
Because there's, I took about four or five of it.
Okay, with the valves, unlike two, this one's got three lugs. This is very interesting. The valve, they're actually on a slope, and it's not a mistake. They've been made that way. So it starts up and it moves down to the centre, and they're all the same. So that might help to identify what model or year. Oh, that's good. That's working too. So number two valve, again, excellent condition. It looks brass. And the third valve. Yep, all in the same very good condition. For the age of the instrument, that's amazing.
Okay, now these are pretty high res, so...
Overall, it's in amazing condition. It's got that very old double water key, which I've only seen on instruments from the late 1800s. But we'll see what comes of that. But it's actually in amazing condition. Oh, there goes the mouthpiece. Incredible condition. Okay, we have a bit of tarnishing around the rim of the bell, but considering the age, but this, that looks to me like it's been put on to hold a marching lyre because of the way the lyres used to clip on the bell. And as you can see, there's no lyre holder spot. So it was probably made for marching in that, and I've never seen that before. Okay, here's a close-up of the bell.
Okay, one of metal in 1862 in London.
Okay, underneath the third valve cap is 8941. Down on the bottom, we have a reinforced piece. So again, I've never seen that before, so I don't know what that involves as well. So here's the exhibit. And yes, that is the same cornet. There's that tubing going, twisting around. That is definitely the same one.
And, all these folk songs, they all sound the same. They all look the same, sound the same. It's like this. I'll make it up as I go along, this is the truth. Oh, get the feeling, wish next to you. Oh, dear. Oh, sing, all the diddle do, all the diddle dee, all the diddle do, diddle dee. Oh, there was once a swimming fellow, and he lived next door. And some the other, and his name was Johnny Blaw. Singing, all the diddle do, all the diddle. Oh, then something went wrong, and he went off to the war. He had something shot off, and he never saw it anymore.
Hi, I'm here at the Spike Milligan Bridge on the outskirts of Woy Woy. I've just come from the library and had a look at the instrument, and while it appeared to be a cornet, Spike used a trumpet mouthpiece. So we're going to have to get to the bottom of that later. But I noticed what amazing condition it was in. It was perfect. The vowels had no wear. It's like 150 years old. No wear, slides all work, no dents, no scratches. So I rang my dear mate, Mal Pierce, who's been my instrument repairer for most of my life. And I said, Mal, I've just played Spike Milligan's cornet. And Mal said, yeah. He says, I serviced it about 20 years ago. Now, Mal's the best, so no wonder it's in such a good condition. But I then spoke to Laura, and she can't actually remember who took it there. It could have been Desmond, Spike's brother, who lived down near Mal. But that's the reason the horn is in such great condition, because it was Mal pierced within the last 20 years. Right, I'm outside 393 Orange Grove Road, Blackwall, which used to be Woy Woy. This was Spike's parents' home from the mid-1950s, and Spike definitely would have played the instrument here at this house. I've just come from the library where I checked a bit of a problem we had. The instrument looks to be a cornet, but Spike always called it his trumpet, and he had a trumpet 7C mouthpiece. I've checked it and I've measured it, and it is definitely a cornet. It's got the conical bore, and how he ended up with a shank that would take a trumpet mouthpiece is just something I guess we'll have to live with, because we can't find out. But so anyway, the house has changed a lot over the years, but it's still got the original shape, and one of the places that Spike spent many years, and they would have heard that cornet being played here quite often. Spike was best known worldwide as a legendary comedian, poet, writer and actor. It's less known that he was a great multi-instrumentalist. While I've concentrated on his cornet and his cornet playing, it's worth noting that he was originally a guitarist with the Bill Hall Trio, shown here in a film in 1947. With Spike on guitar, even though it's pretty hard to identify him. Hope you enjoy this.
Thank you.
How good was that? It's plain to see how naturally Spike combined music with comedy, or was it comedy with music? Geoff Potter told me how the first people that actually got his musical comedy were his fellow soldiers in North Africa during World War II. This love of musical comedy came directly from his love of Spike Jones and his City Slickers, a group that I grew up with loving as well. And it also, of course, led to him taking the nickname Spike. He was also a great piano player and often played piano for the family at home in Woy Woy. Geoff also advised me he started off as a crooner, singing with big bands. Now, whilst it would be hard for Spike to be serious for any amount of time, we have footage here of him from the New London Palladium show, where he's doing his crooning. It shows glimpses of what he did when he first started out, but of course there are smatterings of goonisms all the way.
How about some music? This is the wreck of a song I used to have in a variety act once. That's all that's left of it. Oh, Laura is the face in the mist in her eyes.
I didn't know you could sing.
You can't. Footsteps that you hear down the hall. I'll never forget Laura's face or her footsteps. The laugh,
mischief,
that floats on a summer's night, that you can never quite recall. And you see Laura on a train that is passing through. Those eyes, how familiar they seem. She gave her very first kiss to you.
I'll never forget that first exciting kiss.
She's only a dream.
Spike was also an accomplished composer, composing some great works, including a grand waltz for Brisbane Water, that's the local area up here, which he composed in 1988. The great old legendary Raspberry Song, you better check that one out. And my lifelong favourite, the Ying Tong Song, named after his musical mate, Harry Edgington. Get it? Edge Ying Tong. We also found some photos of Spike playing a trumpet and not cornet. Here's two photos, one from an actual filming or recording of the Goon Show in the 1960s. The other one is from 1974 with his fellow goons. We have no idea where those trumpets ended up, but at least we have Spike's cornet. A few weeks ago, I had the ultimate pleasure of playing Spike's cornet. I have to say, I've played a lot of brass instruments in my time, but this one is amazing. It's 150 odd years old and it's in great condition and it plays absolutely beautifully and it's not high pitch, it's in tune. So what they did is they brought the cornet here to my studio and filmed me playing that cornet along with Spike playing the same cornet years earlier. One from the BBC and a second one from a Perth television concert. So I hope you enjoy these as much as I did in playing them.
Tonight, folks, I was going to play one of Bach's trumpet voluntaries. And then I thought, why should I? He never plays any of mine. So we're going to try, I haven't played this for a long time. We're going to try The Saints Go Marching In. There's not many of them left.
Are you ready, lad? Are you ready? Oh, dear, oh, dear. Keep taking the hormone tablets. Right?
1, 2, 3.
Such a lovely place. It hasn't changed in all the years, really, and you can tell why Spike loved living here. You could get away from the insanity of the fame, which sometimes he embraced, but quite often it did bother him. He was an incredible comedian, as we all know, but he was also a great musician. The archive has actual footage or recordings of him playing piano. And of course, he was way ahead of the curve when it came to things like Indigenous rights and land issues. So this is where we're going to finish up. We're going to leave you here with a beautiful afternoon. I'm going to have my fish and chips and just take some time to reflect on the legend, the king of Woy Woy, Spike Milligan. Thanks for watching. Bye.
No, I'm not mad, really. I just help the others out when they're busy.
It's driving me insane. Oh, put your trousers on and jump down the drain. Oh, ying dong, ying dong, ying dong, ying dong, ying dong.